Hey everybody, how's it going? It's Henry. The rest of the gang is out and about somewhere, probably getting ready for the 4th of July weekend, as I'm sure all of you are. July 1st, Friday, as I recorded this, I'm going to start doing a regular feature. Well, it's going to turn into a regular feature here on our YouTube page, and that is movie reviews. I've got a lot of emails, and you all can keep emailing me, henry@geekspeakradioshow.com. A lot of emails saying that I should do movie reviews. I usually don't. I know we do them sometimes on the radio show. Not on a regular basis, though, but I don't want reviews to become recaps of the movies. If that's the case, you know, just go out and see it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do, number one, spoiler-free reviews, and second, they won't be recaps of the movies that are out there. Right now, there is kind of a big movie out there. You may have heard of it, the Transformers movie, Dark of the Moon. So I'm going to start with that one, obviously. Also, be on the lookout. I know I'm a little late. Sorry. Be on the lookout for reviews for, you know, Thor and everything else. Most of you who are listening to the show right now and listening to this have seen it, but I know some. So I know you out there know some people who actually haven't seen Thor or Super 8 or Kung Fu Panda 2 or any of the other movies that are out there, or Green Lantern even. So have them listen to those reviews before they go out and decide if they want to see the movies or not. So, having said that, without further ado, let us get into the first Geek Speak Radio Show review of Transformers Dark of the Moon. Or
Transformers Dark of the Moon.
Yeah. Anyway, so, hang on. Let me get in the mood. Alright, there we go. So, no secret, even Michael Bay himself has said it, Revenge of the Fallen wasn't all that. Plain, let's just leave it at that. The twins, car beings, as we called them on the show last year, not the best characters, didn't really care about them. The movie was just all over the place. So the main question is, yeah, and by the way, yes, I've seen it, Transformers Dark of the Moon. No, I did not see it in IMAX 3D. I probably will sometime over the weekend again. Decided to go with the 2D. I understand from people who have seen it, the 3D is amazing. It blows away, no pun intended with Michael Bay, but it blows away the 3D that Avatar introduced a few years ago. So if you want to see it, again, don't take my word for it. People that I trust tell me, yes, it's worth the 15, 20 bucks, whatever it is, or whatever bank loan you have to take the whole family out to see it in IMAX 3D, go ahead and do it, because I hear it's worth it. As for the movie itself, it's not better than the first one. It's not worse than the first one. It captured the spirit. Unfortunately, some of the things that were annoying in the second one, Revenge of the Fallen, are still here. They're not as annoying. They don't go on for as long as, like, Michael Bay realizes, oh, wait a minute, they didn't like this, so he pulls back. The twins are not in it. Well, they're kind of shrunk in size this time, and their on-screen time is also shrunk. But there is another character, Ken Jeong, I think is the actor's name. I've never seen The Hangover. People who did, I understand that this is the kind of character he plays in The Hangover, and it grates on you really quick. I understand why I don't want to see movies like The Hangover, if that's what's considered comedy. But he's in there really quick. John Malkovich also is in there really quick. Blink and you may miss him. It really didn't even have a need for him to be in there. It doesn't really do much for the movie. Just actually John Turturro's character, Agent Simmons, he's in this also again. He does return, but he's not as crazy and over the top. I mean, he's a great Turturro as always, but he's not as over the top as he was in the first one, especially in the second one. He's not that over the top. Oh, by the way, you'll remember from Revenge of the Fallen, especially those of you who went to see it in IMAX, Michael Bay gave you a full-on IMAX-sized view of John Turturro's backside. Well, in this one, after we get through the cool introduction and we get the title, the first introduction of the new Megan Fox, as she's being called now, I guess that's a Michael Bay way of saying, sorry for showing you John Turturro's backside. Here's a better looking backside. And in 3D, I guess it looks okay. So look out for that, guys. I'm sure you'll like that one. But Turturro actually is toned down in this one, and he's actually more likable, believe it or not. Like I said, there are a lot of the annoying, unnecessary, quote-unquote, comedy elements are in this one also, but they don't go on as much. The parents are dialed down. I think they're in I think I counted two or three scenes with him total. Sam, believe it or not, Sam actually is, you like him, but he's not that important this time either. I mean, that's kind of the point of the you'll see it, those of you who haven't seen it yet. That's kind of the point of the Sam character this time around. He's not that important, and he doesn't feel that important either. You'll see what I mean once you see it. He's not the main character. For once, the main characters actually are the Transformers themselves. You know, again, who would have thought in a movie called Transformers, the main characters are the Transformers? How about that, huh? Action is typical Michael Bay stuff, exploding. You know, it comes at you, I guess. Again, I didn't see it in 3D, but I guess it comes at you in 3D. The last hour is worth the wait. It really is. The utter destruction of Chicago. And this is why you go see a Transformers movie. This is 8-year-old you with your Optimus Prime, Megatron, Soundwave, all the toys you had before, slamming them into each other, knocking down the books that, you know, you stacked up to be cities, exploding all the G.I. Joes, the Star Wars, everything else that you mixed in with your Transformers toys, and you exploded, everything flew everywhere. This is what you see in the last hour. However, my only complaint, the end. Too abrupt. And you'll see, again, I'm not going to give it away, but you'll see what I mean. It's like, it's going, all of a sudden, directed by Michael Bay. Like, what? That's it? It does leave you wanting more. And now, he has said this will be the last one. Both, you know, 5 days, 6 days, really, over the holiday weekend. It's going to make a ton of money. We'll see if Paramount backs up the Brinks truck to Michael Bay's house and says, how about a fourth one? So, we'll see about that. Oh, and there is one thing that I didn't like about the movie, and that is, you hear this behind me? Yeah, that theme is nowhere in the film, and you really do miss it, especially during that last hour of destruction. It would have been phenomenal if we had this playing in the background, but hey. So that's the review, that's what I'll do. Basically, it comes down to this. I liked it, really did enjoy it. My son and I, we were both 8 years old in that last hour. I'm sure all of you will be too, whether you have 8-year-old kids or not. You are going to be an 8-year-old little boy watching the explosion. There are a lot of moments where, in my crowd that I went with on Wednesday, they cheered, they applauded at just the right times. There's a really, you've seen in the trailer a little bit, there's a really, really cool effect where Bumblebee's in the... on a highway, and Sam is riding, and you finally see, if you've asked this question, if you're riding in a Transformer and the Transformer transforms, what happens to the human gets answered in this movie in a pretty cool way. Look out for that. So basically, like I said, it comes down to this. Better than the first one? No, just about the same. Better than Revenge of the Fallen? Absolutely. Is it worth watching in IMAX 3D? Again, I haven't seen it in IMAX 3D. I hear from people that I trust that yes, it is. So if you want to go that way, go ahead. If you go the 2D way, I think really you're not missing anything, because kind of like the Resident Evil movie last year, it's cool in the beginning. There's a cool rain effect, and you know, it looks like the rain's all around you. But once we got into the movie, I forgot it was even in 3D. I can easily see this movie, Dark of the Moon, going into that. Look out for some cool cameos, by the way. You can stay after the credits, but it really quick. It's just one quick scene, not like the first one. One quick scene, so do stay a little bit after the credits, then go ahead and head on out of the theater. So there you go. That is your first review on the Geek Speak Radio Show for Transformers Dark of the Moon. Again, look out for some reviews that I should have done, I just didn't get to, for Super 8, for Thor, for some of the other movies that have come out. Green Lantern, I haven't seen, quite honestly. I'll probably see it and give you my review of it. But I do know a lot of people that have not seen those movies yet. I know all of you know some people who haven't seen it yet. So have them listen to those and decide if they want to go or not. So also, send me some comments down below, or just send an email to henry@geekspeakradioshow.com. Obviously, I read them since I'm responding to your request for reviews. Let me know what you think. Do you want this to keep going? Do you want the reviews? Do you want more on the reviews? You know, just let me know. Or just say hi. So there you go. First review for the Geek Speak Radio Show, Transformers Dark of the Moon. Oh, and everybody, enjoy and be safe, and happy 4th of July.
Geek Radio Show.